installment of Marking Time in Alliance, a series of programs in which we visit various historical markers and other historical and interesting sites in and around the city of Alliance, Ohio. I'm your host, Jim Perrone, and today we're visiting the site of a marker that commemorates the early history of Alliance. Did you know that the building that is now the Alliance Courthouse was originally Alliance's City Hall? Or that what we now consider the back of the building was really its main entrance? Constructed from 1914 to 1915, Alliance's City Hall replaced an aging frame structure that served the city in its early days. A special bond issue for the building was approved by the voters on September 6, 1913, and work began the following August. By October 1914, the building was ready for the laying of the cornerstone. On November 7th, Service Director James Rickard became an honorary member of the Bricklayers, Masons, and Plasterers Union and received a ceremonial trowel for the event. There were no other formal proceedings for the laying of the cornerstone, and the stone has no lettering on it. The stone, on the northeast corner of the building, does have a box encased in it with the usual cornerstone time capsule items. In place of an inscribed cornerstone, two large brass tablets were produced and placed on either side of the northern entrance to the new City Hall. The tablet on the left is historical in nature and includes the names of those who founded the area: Zacchaeus Biggs, Amos Holloway, Zacchaeus Stanton, Nathan Gaskill, John Grant, David Berry, and Jesse Feltz. It lists the settlement dates as 1827 for Williamsport, 1830 for Freedom, and 1833 for Mount Union. The tablet concludes with the dates of 1854 for Alliance, when it became a village, and 1889, when it became a city. B.F. Weibricht provided the inscription information. The tablet on the right contains the names of the many city officials who were responsible for the building of the structure. This included Mayor W.P. Barnum, who, although responsible for the building, lost his bid for re-election and left office 2 days after the building's official dedication, which took place on December 30th, 1915. Thank you for joining us for this installment of Marking Time in Alliance, as we've been visiting the marker commemorating the early history of Alliance. We'll see you next time on down the road.